the festival has been attended by several friends of mine, actors or directors, and I'm a very good friend of Danny Stanovic, and Danis and I toured together when, you know, when I met him in Los Angeles when he was with No Man Lands, and it was a time of Amores Perros, and we really connect each other. So, you know, through Tani, Danis has been inviting me, and he has been telling me about his city and the festival and how. And then Alfonso Cuarón, for example, that he attended before, he told me that it was a great, or even Pavel, that is a veteran, told me about it. So I heard about the, you know, the spirit of the people here is very special. And I was very impressed about the, as I said, like the festival is really made by the real people, meaning not the film elitist or cinephiles or film critics. It's literally the people in the middle. And that's a very different way of the standard festivals. And I heard that and I proved that. And so I wanted to come, and by different reasons, obviously. Well, I think now that I know a little bit better Miro, the director, now I understand who's the person behind, and I think the idea is brilliant, because I think in a way art expressions and these kind of spaces where people can express themselves through, in this case, an art form as cinema, and the people can be exposed to different ways and different stories, and different sides probably of the same story. It's a fertile territory to reconciliation or to let out frustration, anger, sadness, and share something, or even disagree in something, but to be able to express or understand each other. So I think it's a brilliant idea, and not only as a cultural event, but as you said, as a humanistic and as a healing space, you know, I think that was a very great idea to start even during the war. And politicians and people generally does not relate how important, or does not understand how important is art for society. So, I mean, I think it can really change the dynamics of any society, any art, and I think in this case, to expose this festival here, it's a healing wound kind of thing. Yeah, I think that the film, the world actually has become a TV show, and the real things has now been experienced by us as an optical illusion through our screens or through our TVs, and very, very mental health damaged people, and meaning sociopaths, narcissistic, cynics, even psychopaths, has taken the power, but they are using the extremely successful entertaining tool, which is the digitalization and the globalization and the spread, the immediate spread of that, that we all consume. And it's hard to divide the reality of that things being real from the way we experience through the screen, because at the same time, 1 minute later, we are seeing the pictures of our one-year-old niece, and then we are sending a lovely letter to somebody. But in that same screen, everything is passing, and reality and fiction, and our life is an optical illusion now. And this has been very difficult to understand, that the way we consume that reality, yes, it's been taken advantage by the media, by TV channels that in a way spread whatever interest, left, right, whatever. And the guys that supposedly should be the guy who knows better to use proper language, great thoughts, higher ambitions, of they are the most vulgar, the most ignorant, and they are monkey showrunners, monkey showmen. And it's funny to see them in a TV show. And that's what the people is consuming, but that cannot be the guy who really drive the reality. And so that combination has been lethal, plus the algorithm dictatorship, which in a way feed people with more of what they are consuming, and everybody's going even harder to that radical vision of whatever they are consuming, left and right, meaning both sides. So if you open a left wing or whatever, you will be just basically bombarded by that. And your vision even will become even further away from the right wings, that they will be the killers. And obviously the right wingers will become like more mad about that. It's a very scary moment we are living. I don't know how to stop it, but how we will stop it. But it's a scary. It's a combination of incendiary elements, I think.
You know, I have a few people that I trust. And those are almost the same people since I start. And I think the reason is because I know that the comments that will come from them, first of all, will come from the right side, which is the side of the heart, you know, that with good intentions, not with any other, and which only interest will be, they will not be basically trying to please me, but they will try to make, at least in their point of view, whatever material I'm working with, the piece that I'm working better. So it's in the interest of this, not me or my feelings or my ego. Those couple of questions obviously are very important for me to hear, because in a way, somebody always can point you something that you have not seen, considerate, or can open the door of something that you have not even think. And even pointing some door, then you open the door and there's another territory that you explore, but it's good to suddenly be point about things to explore more. Or actually, especially more that I think is the confusion thing, that sometimes because you know what you are talking about or you understand and you know the whole thing, you assume people will travel with you easily. And suddenly, if there's some confusion or there's something that is not well written or well solved, not to be to explain and clear out everything, no, but if there's confusion, I like mystery and sometimes things that are more impenetrable and is part of the, but if there's a confusion, so people can help you if there's a stone in the road, it's good to understand it and take it out. And honestly, many times I do not agree, and other things I agree. So I think it's my work to be truthful to what I want and choose the things, the battles that really I don't care who agree or not, and the other ones that I consider to be important and open the door for even better solutions that I had originally. So it has worked for us very well that way, you know. I think I'm lucky, let me put it that way, I'm very lucky. I don't find a lot of directors with that benefit of not only friendship, but that we share kind of same problems or doubts, and that's a very beautiful advantage for the film. I think there has to be maybe a halfway, right? I think if you know all the answers or you know exactly where this is going, I think then you are basically not having a journey. You are just basically being a carpenter, putting together a piece of wood and making a bed, you know, a spectate working table with four legs, and that's it. I think there's a part that it's important that you know what you want, and more importantly, what is not that thing that you want. All the things that this thing is not. I think at least that's a very important halfway you have to be. That you know, to recognize what is any element, a face of an actor, a word that does not belong, a location, the rhythm of things, the music, I mean, every element that will conform that, you have to know what is not that. And you have to know what you want. Now, the journey is where to find those things and start from the casting, from all of that, and then once you have all the elements, the cooking of the plate is the journey. Is that mix of elements can be infinite possibilities And I think it's better not to know perfectly, because then the fun ends. It has to be like a playground for kids, and play and discover and fail and then return and do it better and then discover something that is unexpected. And then, you know, end up with something inevitable but not expected. And I think, so it's a halfway, you know. And I think fear can drive young filmmakers to try to understand everything and know everything, and that paralyzes you. That can paralyze you because you would like to control everything, expecting that the result will be that, then you will fail for sure because nothing will be what you expect. You will be shooting and suddenly a location will fall apart and then an actor will be sick, you will have to find another, so your mind will get crazy. So, and there's other young filmmakers I have found that they said, well, I want to be the next Stanley Kubrick. And I said, well, you know, Stanley Kubrick only, there's one in a lifetime, that's it, you know. So it's a dangerous thing. And there are another ones that are very doubtful, that they don't know exactly what they want. So it's a tricky balance, I guess.